You have a whole series of O-rings in here and a shaft that you rotate.
So, on the space station, how many of these would you have?
Seven, because we have seven windows.
What happens if you get a leak on that?
Then you have a leak.
O-ring type seals.
No, you don't.
With a rotating shaft. All our hatch seals are O-ring type seals.
Yeah, but how...
My brain's
up here. Let's go inside. We can see it.
Okay.
Watch All right. your head.
All right.
Oh, oops, thunk.
Still taking calls on those UFO sightings. I'm on the line with Jennifer, who claims to have actually met aliens.
Gary, I have been sucked up by alien spacecraft many times.
Uh-oh.
And I can tell you, they are among us.
Really? Now, what do you suppose they want?
Well, they want my eggs.
Uh-huh.
To start their own alien race.
Whoa, thanks for calling. Hello, you're on the air.
So why didn't I flinch? Because the laws of science differ fundamentally from those of...
The vast majority of images of Earth that you have seen are not photographs. They're made by a guy using Photoshop, and this is a fact. Look at how different each official NASA image of Earth is. The last time an official photograph of the Earth was taken was during 1972 on one of the Apollo missions. The issue with this is, of course, the issues with the Apollo missions.
If I only have a minute and a half, and I don't really need to hear what you're trying to provide, I want to know how you're dealing with all these conspiracy theorists on your platform.
So the first way is by demoting low-quality content and promoting more authoritative content, and the second is by providing more transparency for users. So we're introducing boxes that provide factual information at the top of results that have shown themselves to turn up a lot of information that is counterfactual, such as searching for the Earth is flat on YouTube, where you see a lot of...
Your response is to put streaming. A box saying, nope, the Earth is not flat.
Correct.
Okay.
Hold up. Hey. My niggas who be thinking we soft, we don't play. We gon' rock it till the wheels fall off. Hold up, hey. Well, my niggas who be acting too bold, take a seat. Hope you're ready for the next episode. Hey,
we're actually seeing a mirage.
A mirage.
To go on Lake Michigan and determine whether or not the Chicago skyline, as viewed from the other side of Lake Michigan, was in fact a mirage.
More people need to get out there and question why they believe what they believe. You know, just get out there and start doing tests for yourself. Because when you see it for yourself, that's a game changer.
Rick, what are you trying to prove to people?
A mirage.
I'm not proving anything. The water does it on its own. By the way, we are literally standing right where Rob Steve and I stood.
42 times 42
when we did our test.
A mirage, a mirage, a mirage, a mirage, a mirage, a mirage. What you're seeing here is a mirage. You typically would not be able to see this from the Lake Michigan shore. We talked about this last night. Conditions are right on the lake that we're actually seeing a mirage of the Chicago skyline.
Best explained as simply a mirage.
I'm Neil deGrasse Tyson, and I'm here to tell you how f***ing rad space is.
Alan Dulles brought in all the Nazi scientists and so forth. They went to two places. They went to CIA and they went to the National Aeronautics and Space Administration, which in our world we call it not a space agency. And as Kathy O'Brien has said so clearly, that's where the bulk of the mind control has been done.
Operation Paperclip smuggled hundreds of Nazi scientists, including top SS officers on trial for war crimes, into the United States for use in America's Cold War space race. One of these Nazi Party members, Wernher von Braun, was promoted to head up NASA's Marshall Space Flight Center. Under Operation Paperclip, some 350 German scientists and former intelligence agents were given visas and well-paying jobs. The purpose of this massive and illegal undertaking appears to have been for the establishment of a worldwide authority on all things relating to space and astronomy. NASA became the public face of space. It has long acted as a front, providing an unsuspecting world with pseudoscience legitimized by the backing of the US government. NASA is its own monopoly. It controls the dissemination of public information on astronomy while hiding facts it does not want the public to know. For hundreds of years, the Vatican has owned more telescopes and observatories than any organization, private university, or government. NASA and the Vatican jointly own Lucifer, the world's largest binocular telescope. According to the official Vatican website, the Vatican Observatory is one of the oldest astronomical institutes in the world. And yet, where are the photographs? Where are the news releases of the latest discoveries? Precisely what have the Jesuit astronomers been doing for the last 500 years? Only they know. NASA's public release of information promoting the idea of an expanding, thus ever larger universe of incomprehensible size has led to the supposition there must be alien life on other planets. In combination with Hollywood and the science fiction genre,